economic backbone. Texas politicians stubbornly resisted northern demands to expand the civil rights for African Americans. In 1867, an exasperated General Philip Sheridan, commander of the military district that controlled Texas during Reconstruction, fired the governor and a host of state officers. One federal official remarked that Texas was more defiant than other southern states because, quote, had not been good during the war. The post-war years also were marked by lawlessness and violence. In an effort to end rampant cattle rustling along and across the border, the state hired a Confederate veteran, the name of Leander H. McNally. McNally and his rangers put a stop to the rustling, actually by killing the rustler. Their take no prisoners tactics brought peace to the border, but earned the rangers the hatred of many Mexican Americans. On the frontier, the state suffered from Indian raids. After nearly losing his own scalp to a Kiowa attack, Army Commander General William Sherman ordered Colonel Randall McKenzie to pursue the Comanches into their strongholds in the Panama. McKenzie slaughtered the Indian forces and destroyed their villages. In 1875, Juan Parra, the last of the Comanche warriors, surrendered his tribe. Economically, Texas began to recover. Cotton rebounded, and the cattle business practically exploded. In 1871, Texas drovers moved 700,000 head of cattle to the railheads in Kansas. The need to get cattle and other products to market fueled the railroad building premises remaining tenants for 2 decades. To stimulate railroad construction, the state offered companies free land in exchange for every mile of new track. With enthusiasm, however, the legislature gave away 8 million acres more land than the state actually possessed. As Texas moved into the 20th century, a new and dominant industry arose. Oil. In 1901, the first well blew in the Spindle Top field near Boulder. 3 decades later, Texas became the leading oil producing state. East Texas oil fields about Junior, whose Texas production passed California and Oklahoma. Fresh problems along the U.S.-Mexico border emerged in 1900. In the next decade, Mexico was torn by revolution. Some of the members like Contravino were little more than vendors. When his men raided several towns on the U.S. side of the border, President Woodrow Wilson sent troops to pursue them. The Texas economy continued to grow and change. The next World War ended, the state and much of the rural society were fully dissolved, from an agricultural economy to an industrial economy. Today, we're still an independent nation. Texas would have the 8th largest economy in the world. It is truly a giant among states.